Welcome to J.A.T, Just A Thought Our Videos. Firstly, Happy New Year 2016! I'm very excited to bring to you this video on my new Mi TV 2 55-inch. It includes the soundbar and the subwoofer. The Mi TV is not officially sold in Malaysia yet, but I managed to purchase this unit from an online e-commerce store for approximately 3,900 ringgit. And it was delivered just a few days ago. I felt it was a good buy because after surveying the electronic shops, to get a 4K 55-inch TV alone will typically cost above 4,000 ringgit. So, in this video, I wish to share with you my experience setting it up and how I changed the user interface from Chinese to English and some learning points. So let's get started. This is the home screen, called Mi Home. As you can see, it's presently in English because I had already performed some steps which I will demonstrate to you. Firstly, you can see the inputs, some options for the movie and TV, games and apps, smart home, and more importantly, let's go to the settings. Down here, we have the general settings and also about me. So let's go over here and have a look. As you can see, the Mi TV firmware version at the moment is 1.1.92 stable. When I first got the TV, it was actually pre-installed with the firmware of version 1.1.70 stable. Now this is an important point. With the firmware version of 1.1.70, I was able to install an app called XH Home for TV as per the advice from other YouTubers and Mi Forum. But as you can see, with this new firmware version of 1.1.92, I was not able to install it. But I was still able to change this to English because I found another way. And I'm going to show it to you now. To show you how it's done, changing the user interface from Chinese to English when it's installed with the firmware version of 1.1.92, I'm going to perform a factory reset and take you through step by step. So let's get started by going to the settings. We need to go down to the general settings, and as you can see, it's in English. And what I'm going to do now is to just scroll down to factory reset. Click on the OK. I will remove all the apps so it will feel like as per when the TV was first started up. So let's just go do a reset. Erase all personal information. Yes, we shall do that. Here we go. It will take some time to perform this reset, so at certain points, I will be speeding up the video just to save you some time. When you first start up your Mi TV, straight out of the box, this is what you'll see. It'll take a few moments to boot up or to configure, and I will speed up the video here just to save you some time. Right. Now the initial setup is quite straightforward. So as you can see, that was just the welcome screen, and we will just need to follow the instructions by clicking on the select button a few times. Okay, another time. And we need to connect to the Wi-Fi, so just allow me to do that now quickly. Okay, the Wi-Fi is connected. Just a few more screens to go through. Now, this is to set up the Mi account, but this only works if you have a China Mi account. Even though I have a Malaysia Mi account, I won't be able to use it, so I should just go up here and skip this step. Next, we need to set up the subwoofer as well as the soundbar, so we'll just follow the instruction on screen. Okay, now it needs to pair the soundbar to the subwoofer. And that's done. That was just the Dolby Surround demo, and I was actually pretty excited when I first saw it. Okay, let's proceed. And welcome home to Mi Home. Now, as you can see, this interface now is back to its default or factory reset, where it's actually in Chinese. So let's go back to the settings screen again, just to confirm the firmware version. And as you can see, it's back to version 1.1.92, and it runs on Android 5.0.1 Lollipop. With this version, it does not allow me to install the XH Home for TV, which was suggested to assist us to change the UI to English. I will just quickly demonstrate it now. So I'm pressing back to go back to the home screen. I have copied the APK to the thumb drive and have connected it to the TV. And we're going to the thumb drive now. Okay, these are a few APKs that I have actually copied to the thumb drive in preparations to set it up. So this is XH Home for TV APK, which was initially suggested and was working well with the version of 1.1.70. However, with this version of 1.1.92 firmware, as I try to install it, now, the first time you're installing a third-party app, it will bring you to this screen, which basically tries to prevent you unless you have enabled the installation of third-party apps. So we just need to go down to this option, click OK, move up, enable it, yes, confirm, move to the option on the left, enable it, and when we go back to the list of files, you can see that installation has been enabled. However, do not be fooled, because even though when I try to install it, it shows that it is not successful. So, what to do now? Don't worry, I'll show you what I did. This is what I've done, and I've used Safa Market instead. So just let me go back up over here. We shall just quickly install this. Scroll all the way down to share its permissions. Install. Okay, installation is successful. So let's get it started. Launching it. Now for the first time you launch it, it will prompt you whether you want to install some tools. I'll just normally skip that with the option on the right. And it will prompt you as well whether to update it to the latest version of Safa Market. And you shall accept this. Just a quick download. Okay, so it will prompt us to install again to the latest version. Once that is done, let's launch it. Just some advertisement. Okay, now, the good thing about this particular app is that it actually has its own English interface. So what we can do is to go up to the most top right corner, this screen, and we just need to go down to the settings, which is this option on the left lower button. Click on it, and we just need to scroll down past this one. You can see this one, root. We just need to go down to this third option, and we can change it to English. Now, we are not done yet, because this only changes the Safari Market's interface to English. The next thing we need to do now is to actually install the Safari TV launcher, which is at the bottom here. Okay, you just need to click OK, install. It'll prompt you about the permissions this particular app needs. Go all the way down, select the option on the right to install it. Right, let's launch it. Okay, this is the Safari TV launcher, and as you can see, a very basic screen setup. Now, we need to go down to this particular option, which is actually the systems. So just click OK, go down to the settings, right? Looks familiar? So we just need to go all the way down to this one, which is actually the language and input setting. Click on it. The first one is the option that you are looking for. You just need to click on this and search the language of English, United States. Select. Voila! Now it's in English. Am I pulling a leg? No. Let's go back to the Mi Home. There you have it, ladies and gentlemen. The input now. TV and home, the games, the apps, smart home, and even if you go to the settings, it's all in English, making it much, much easier for you to navigate and enjoy this TV. We will want to just turn off the intelligent update for the time being, because we do not know what the newer firmware version offers. But ladies and gentlemen, here you have it. How to change the UI from Chinese to English if your Mi TV has been upgraded to the firmware of version 1.1.92. I'm very excited with the possibilities of this TV, and I do look forward to creating more videos about the experience and the feel of it and share it with you all soon. I hope this video has been helpful to you all, and I thank you for watching this video. If you have any comments, feedback or questions, please feel free to leave them in the comment box below and I'll get back to you. If you found this video to be helpful, please give it a thumbs up and subscribe. I look forward to your feedback and also to bring you more videos in the future. Thank you, and signing off now.